near somewhere, George. It's got to be. Area.
All killings within a mile of each other.
Yeah, it could be local, but they used a coach. Method.
Organs removed.
Could be medical, but there's no proof. And they're drenched in blood.
Yeah, so they're going to wash the clothes or throw them away.
And if they throw them away,
they can't won't be poor.
Llewellyn.
Our own police surgeon, local, uncooperative, and he's got, of course, medical knowledge.
But he had an alibi for the Nichols murder. The question mark. Lusk.
Political, violent, and he knows the area.
But did he have the knowledge? Lees.
The Queen's own psychic medium, no doctor's knowledge, and he's got an alibi for the Chapman murder.
But he described the knight in shining armour.
Ackland, doctor, attended Chapman's inquest with a very weak excuse.
Leave him on. Mansfield.
Your friend the actor. Alibi for the Chapman killing. But he knows about autopsies because Ackland showed him one.
Underline him. Is that all?
Yeah. Mind you, you're pretty good with a razor.
So are you. Put us both down.
Sir, look. I wear lipstick, I wear rouge, I wear mascara on my eyelashes, I dye my hair, I wear flamboyant clothes, far more outré than those I'm wearing now. I am a self-evident, self-professed, effeminate homosexual for all the world to see. How could I hope to solicit anybody in broad daylight in a crowded London street looking as I do? What would I expect but a curse and a blow? No. My appearance sets me apart from the rest of humanity. It is not easy for me to make human contacts. With strangers, it is almost impossible. I learned many years ago the golden rule of my life. In public places, I do not speak to anyone unless they speak to me. I do not look at anyone unless they demand that I look at them. It is the only way I know of getting safely to my destination.
Fine show of rhododendrons. And the Philadelphus?
Just out.
Just out. And smelling sweetly. And is our guest with us?
Yes, dear, Elizabeth is here.
I've often wondered about my son. Does he treat girls well?
Now, why have you wondered that?
Well, I once knew a fella called Arthur Pennyquick. He was like you in many ways. He didn't treat girls well.
Please, dear, I don't think Arthur Pennyquick's quite suitable.
Oh, do tell us. What did he do to girls?
Well, disgusting.
You think if you sleep with someone, you should trust them with your cufflinks?
Well, not remove them in front of the gal. Well, we've seen a fine show of rhododendrons.
Yes, dear, and I showed you the polyanthus.
Yes, yes. The result of much laboursome potting up.
Why do you bother?
What?
I said, why do you bother to do all this gardening? I mean, when you can't see it.
Elizabeth.
Well, he can't, can he? Why do we all walk about pretending he's not blind?
Is this you?
Yes.
Would you take me down to the West Copse? I'd like a report on the magnolia. Would you do that? Be my eyes.
Come then.
Mornings at 7. Or rather, just past 10:30. The hillsides dew-pearled, the larks on the wing, the snails on the thorn, God's in his heaven. With any luck at all, there's a little crime going on somewhere in the world. Robert Browning, the Rumpole version. What's on today? Main course, a committal at Bow Street. Hors d'oeuvre, a conference with a vicar. The trouble with vicars is They make the most terrible witnesses.
And if you think the hotels of crowded Saint-Tropez are too expensive, and you want a do-it-yourself holiday with more comfort than a tent, yet all the freedom in the world, head for Port Grimaud, a village just a couple of miles from Saint-Tropez that presents the same artist's picture of coastal Provence. But here, canals instead of roads, because this is France's Little Venice, an old Provençal fishing village, just 7 years of age. Yet among the expensive private houses are holiday homes to rent. An air package two-week holiday for four people in an apartment here costs just over £80 each in high season. If you come independently by car, four of you could have the same holiday in a two-bedroom waterside house for £32.50 each. And just off peak in June and September, eight of you could get an even better deal. A four-bedroom old fisherman's cottage with all mod cons, like this one, for a shared rent which works out at £20 a fortnight each. And at that bargain price, you can take a boat from your own back door. Merci.
I was in Margate last summer for the summer season. A friend of mine said, you want to go to Margate? It's good for rheumatism. So I did, and I got it. And I tried to get the hotel. It was packed, so it was this big boarding house. And I knocked at the door of the landlady, put her head at the window. She said, what do you want? I said, I want to stay here. She said, well, stay there, shut the window. And while I was there, I bought one of these skin diving outfits. Let me see, like a frogman suit. Bought the whole thing, you know, goggles, big flippers, tank on the back. And I had a photograph taken like that and like that. Well, you never know, do you? You never know.
Hey, hold it, Emu. Emu, hold it, Emu. May I please have a little word with Rod?
What is it?
Yes, Rod. Oh, boy. Hello, Emu.
You can't come in here either.
Yes, I can, because tonight, Rod Hull, this is your life.
Your chance.
Admiral of the fleet, the Earl Mountbatten of Burma, tonight, this is your life.
What do you mean?
Terry Wogan, this is your life.
I wish I'd shaved.
Afternoon, Captain. My name is Michael Aspel. I've flown over from London. I know you're expecting to be interviewed, but in fact, my mission is to say to you tonight, William Shatner, this is your life.
You're kidding.
Jean-Jacques Gabor, a name is on this book, it is
yes.
Yours.
Oh,
this is your life,
oh
Jean-Jacques
Gabor. My life, one book, I sort of said.
People totally underestimate the impact of the surprise of This Is Your Life. It's like going into territory and suddenly the signposts are taken away and the calendars are torn up and the wall is put on the face of the clock and you don't know where you are and you have to reorientate the whole thing.
With your permission.
The answer is no.
I would like to show you a very special bit of magic.
Oh, that's different.
In your honor, that a lot of your good friends and I have been practicing. Because you see, tonight, Eamon Andrews, this is your life.
Come on, I've got you. I've got you. Trust me. Trust me.
You really?
Yes, sir.
You're joking.
Is it really, he said. Those were the classic words. All right. You recognize this place?
Yes, I do.
It's not much, but it's home.
You know, really have fooled it, have you?
You know where to sit? That's the one.
Good day, greeting, are you? I had no idea I should have to be buried alive in a month.
Nor I. It's the very first I've heard of it.
But it makes a difference, the doesn't it?
It does make a difference, of course.
You see, buried alive, well, it's such a stuffy death.
I call it a beast of a death.
You see my difficulty, don't you?
Yes, and I see my own. If I insist on you carrying out your promise, I doom you to a hideous death. If I release you, you marry Coco at once.